With every new discovery, the field of neuroscience reveals new questions for further inquiry into the wonders of the brain and mind. Today, the field's dynamic growth worldwide reflects both the scientific opportunity and excitement created in pursuit of one of science's greatest challenges. Shaping this future will take many minds, voices, and perspectives.
I get to touch with these very same hands the human brain every day. I'm talking about brain that is alive. And I touch it, I feel it, I go in and I carve these tumors out. And then on top of that, I make my patients, with their permission, part of history. Why? Because we send their tissue to my laboratory to study and hopefully one day find a cure for brain cancer.
The Society for Neuroscience is the world's largest organization of scientists and physicians devoted to advancing understanding of the brain and nervous system. From its inception in 1969, the Society has led the way in bringing together scientists of diverse backgrounds to achieve this goal. SFN is proud to celebrate 30 years of supporting diversity by nurturing young minority scientists through its Neuroscience Scholars Program.
All scientists now recognize, and maybe neuroscientists were one of the first to recognize, the importance of diversity, and that diversity by itself leads to excellence in research and education and medical care, and that the Society valued diversity both in its mission and in its strategic plan.
We will reach further, faster, when we have different ideas and different concepts, different thinking, different approaches to problem solving in the field of neuroscience.
Brain sciences are incredibly interesting and exciting, have huge implications for a number of disorders and diseases, and it's clear that we need the best and brightest from wherever they come to join us and participate in doing research in the neurosciences.
30 years ago, recognizing the importance of having a diverse neuroscience community and the relative underrepresentation of minorities in the field, SFN leadership explored ways to encourage and support aspiring minority neuroscientists. The result was a traveling fellowship program, the forerunner to the Neuroscience Scholars Program. The program immediately caught the attention of the National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke.
NINDS has funded the Neuroscience Scholars Program for 30 years. We are very proud of having supported it. Over 500 people have participated in it. And if you look at the outcome measures, metrics, very clear that the opportunities provided by the Neuroscience Scholars Program have actually been of benefit in their career development. We have other programs, but in terms of bang for the buck, this is probably our best program.
The NSP has evolved over the years into a vibrant and highly competitive 3-year fellowship program offering a range of benefits. The program seeks to address the phenomenon called the leaky pipeline. While underrepresented minorities express interest in careers in science and technology at similar rates as whites and Asian students, the representation of these groups decreases with each higher educational and professional level.
The program has 4 components: Society for Neuroscience membership, travel support to attend the annual meeting of the Society for Neuroscience, a matching with a mentor who works with them both during the meeting and beyond, and enrichment funds to attend other scientific courses, conferences, or visits to other labs.
I feel a huge sense of joy for the Scholars Program because it gave me an opportunity to network. It gave me an opportunity to see the big names that I read about in books.
The Neuroscience Scholars Program really helped me learn how to cultivate relationships as colleague to colleague,
both by promoting networking and by directly funding my research efforts. The NSP has really been critical for my career as I've transitioned from postdoc to assistant professor.
The Neuroscience Scholars Program nurtures a strong sense of community for minority scientists, many of whom face additional challenges as minorities.
The biggest challenge that I had when I started doing research and being in this field was that sometimes I was the only one in a lab or the only one in a department or the only minority, sometimes even in the school.
Doing any kind of a graduate program is like running a race uphill. Doing a graduate program as an underrepresented minority is like running a race uphill with a bunch of hurdles in front of you.
The program empowers people, give them opportunities that they didn't have before. Take talented people and put them in a position to be more competitive. And that is what we need.
To help meet these challenges, the Neuroscience Scholars Program also fosters lasting mentoring relationships, a critical element in helping individuals overcome those challenges on the road to successful scientific careers.
In the Scholars Program, you form mentors for life. And the mentors that I had, like Jim Townsend, Joe Martinez, back when I was a scholar, are still my mentors today.
From the day that I got my PhD, I was committed to expanding opportunities for underrepresented minority kids in science. I wanted them to enjoy the route that I had found that made me so happy.
Having a mentor in the NSP program was just so important as I was thinking about my ideas for research and trying to pitch them both to a physics audience but also to a neuroscience audience at large.
The impact of the Society for Neuroscience through Dr. Martinez's mentorship when I was at UC Berkeley was undoubtedly one of the most important building blocks in my life.
It's important to reach back, and so that's what I'm doing now, is mentoring students and mentoring undergrad students and graduate students. And, you know, that's the only way you're going to really be able to kind of close the pipeline and make sure that underrepresented minorities are able to really get into the field of neuroscience and make a significant impact.
Over the last 30 years, former scholars in the program have made remarkable gains, both in their individual careers and in their contributions to their chosen field of neuroscience.
In my recent work, I'm actually merging dance with science, in that we found that species that have the ability to imitate vocalizations like parrots and songbirds do for what we do for speech, they have brain pathways that are specialized for that ability, as we do, right? That you cannot find in non-human primates or chickens. And what we found is that those brain pathways in the song learning birds, and we think that it's the case for humans, are embedded within brain pathways that control motor sequence movement behavior.
When I started 30 years ago, there was only a few groups that thought that there were gender differences, and people used to look at you like, that's not true, or, you know, how can that be? And now it's a given that there is gender difference and that women and men act differently to drugs or to diseases. So I'm very proud because I started really early with this question, is there a difference between male and female? And now that I see it, that is a common thing on textbooks, makes you kind of proud to be there from the beginning.
When I look back on the Neuroscience Scholars Program, I realized what a significant impact it had on my career and how I used that program to help build on leadership skills that allowed me to interact with investigators.
The Neuroscience Scholars Program, while offering unique opportunities that have contributed to successful scientific careers, also enables former scholars to give back the benefits of the program to younger generations.
The scientific community, we need to have more people from underrepresented backgrounds to be in these faculty positions or in industry where they can really make a difference.
As the field of neuroscience continues to evolve and expand, so will the impact of the Neuroscience Scholars Program. Its continued success will foster professional achievement for future generations of underrepresented minority neuroscientists. And it will enrich the future for all of neuroscience by bringing new minds, voices, and perspectives to solve tomorrow's next great scientific challenges.